D.L. Hughley breaks the news. CNN, Saturday night at 10, Sunday night at 11.
The stock market is down and AIG gets billions more in bailout money. And you're thinking, why should I care? Here with me now is the money coach and author of Zero Debt, Lynette Cialfani-Cox. How you doing, gorgeous?
I'm great. Thank you for having me.
So, AIG, why should we care?
Well, you know, I know a lot of people are saying, first of all, where's my bailout?
Right, and
you know, why are we throwing what they perceive to be good money after bad? The reason we should care, frankly, is that this company is massive in size. We're talking about one of the biggest global insurers in the world.
Right.
They've got more than 70 million policyholders worldwide, including 30 million just in the U.S. alone. So you might not even know that you could stand to benefit potentially from a policy. Somebody might have a life insurance policy with right. AIG, for example, and you might be the beneficiary of it and not even know it. So this company is deemed too big to fail. Remember back in September when Lehman Brothers went under, and that kind of started with the whole financial crisis really being accelerated. Mm-hmm. So now I think the government is saying, look, we don't want another repeat of that scenario. What can we do to step in? I understand the logic, though. A lot of people are saying, right. how come we're giving so much money when they just lost $62 billion right. in the fourth quarter alone? It's
look,
amazing.
You can hear him turning into Oprah. Mm-hmm.
Crazy. It's crazy.
But
so
I, you know,
they've got to have much better set of management and financial. They're supposed to be a risk management company.
Right.
They're supposed to be able to protect against these kind of things. But clearly, they haven't been doing a good job.
You know, it really came home to me when we were talking about the segment, when I was reading some articles. And about you, and my producer came over. She told me her mother had a conversation. She was watching, she was over her house, and she was watching the financial reports, and it talked about AIG. And she said, you know, I have annuities set up for you and with that company. So if it goes down, you lose your money. And that's when all of a sudden she got
interested. The producer was like, oh!
Like yeah, how people, did it get this bad?
Though? Right. You know, I think a whole bunch of things got into place. Clearly the mortgage crisis has played a role. They also insured complex derivatives. They provided insurance for corporate bonds. All of those things went bad. And frankly, I just don't think they had the controls in place. They provided some forms of insurance where they shouldn't have been. We're in it now. Almost $180 billion worth. That's a massive amount of money.
You know what's funny about this? The stock market's down below 7,000. And the reason I remember that was because in 1997, my wife and I decided to get into the stock market, and it was 7,000.
And now you're back where
you
were
before. And now we're back where we started. We've come full circle.
I want to give your viewers a little bit of perspective, because I think too often we're getting a little bit caught up in the negativity and the gloom and doom, all the, you know, bad headlines we're seeing. Yes, the market is doing terribly right now. Nobody's going to question that.
Then that's gloom and doom. Well, so what you going to say?
hold on now. I got some hope for you.
Right.
I mean, I guess my message is that you shouldn't be overly depressed or overly concerned that this situation cannot or will not ultimately turn around. Is it going to take some time? Absolutely, yes. On the stock market front, frankly, nobody has a crystal ball.
But should we stay in the market? Should we?
I think that if you're a younger person, absolutely, you still should be investing in stocks.
So you say if you're 50 or younger,
absolutely.
You stay in the
if you're a pre-retiree or in retirement, now we're talking a whole new ball game
right.
because those folks are going to have to make some very tough choices.
Right.
For a lot of them, they might have to downsize and move from one house to a smaller house or perhaps to a different part of the country that's less expensive. They might have to work longer. I think in this environment, everybody should plan for a pink slip even if they're absolutely certain they won't receive one. So you should be having...
Woman, I thought you said you had good news. Where is that at?
Well, you know...
Plan for a pink slip.
Well, some of the good news is frankly what we're seeing from President Obama and
right.
the administration. You know, this week we got some great news for homeowners who might be at risk of foreclosure, some assistance, a real lifeline being thrown to people there. And I actually think that $75 billion plan is going to do a lot of good. It is going to stop some of the foreclosures that we've been seeing.
Well, you have given us some good information. Give it up for Lynette Cialfani-Cox.